everyone. Welcome to our channel, Biology for All. In this video, I'm going to talk about the process of absorption and assimilation. In my previous video, I have already talked about the absorption of nutrients in various parts of the alimentary canal. So, absorption is a process by which the digested food nutrients are taken up from the digestive tract into the bloodstream. The absorption mainly happens, or maximum amount of absorption happens, in the small intestine. As we all know, the small intestine has structures called as villi and microvilli. This increases the surface area for absorption of the digested nutrients. Now, from the lumen of the small intestine, the glucose and amino acids enters into the capillaries inside these villi. So, they enter by a process that is the active transport. The fatty acids enter into the lacteal, that is the large lymph vessel. The blood capillaries that move out from the villi contains large amount of nutrients, or we can say that this blood is rich in nutrients as they have taken up the digested nutrients from the small intestine. These capillaries join together and form the hepatic portal vein. Hepatic portal vein is a blood vessel that is formed by capillaries arising from the small intestine and the stomach, and then it enters into the liver. So this structure here is the hepatic portal vein. Now, the hepatic portal vein takes all the digested nutrients, mainly glucose and amino acids, to the liver. In the liver, excess of glucose is converted to glycogen and stored, and the excess of amino acids are broken down into urea to be excreted. Whatever remaining glucose and amino acids are sent to the blood circulation is used up for our body in the form of energy, that is glucose is used to produce ATP, and amino acids are the building blocks in our body. So this process of utilization of the absorbed nutrients is what we call as assimilation. So this is the process of absorption and assimilation in our body.